Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingles all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, Great Age Movement, want to wish you a Merry Christmas. And now for some real singing. Here's Trisha. Great Age Movement wants to wish you a prosperous new year as well. Merry Christmas.
Ho, 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 Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, and Happy Kwanzaa, and soon to be, Happy New Year. Welcome to the Great Age Movement at Home Lab Series in partnership with the Health Museum. This is our final show for 2020, and we have a very special Christmas gift to you. My name is Fritz McDonald, and our show is about health and wellness, and includes a whole lot more, including DIY projects, cooking, beauty tips, home safety, you name it. Today, I'd like to introduce a special guest of ours. Her name is Trisha Tangai. She has quite the voice, and she will be singing some songs with you. Welcome, Trisha Tangai.
Hello, everyone. Good morning. Oh, my goodness. Could not think of a better way to spend the morning after Christmas. My family and I have celebrated. I'm coming to you live today from our home here in Cleveland, Ohio. It is much chillier here than it is in Texas. So do me a favor and send me some warmth, okay?
I'll send you my hat.
Okay, please do. Oh my goodness. Woo! It was a nice 15 degrees yesterday, and I'm pretty sure it's around that today. 15 degrees. Can you So come on, Texas, send us that sun. So I am so thrilled. Fritz, thank you so much for having me. And I'm so thrilled to be here to work with you today and to bring some of you some new experiences today that you might not have had before. So as a singer, there's many assumptions, I think, that a lot of us that might just stand very still when we warm up our voices, but that isn't the case. So no matter where you are, just like I'm in my home today, and I happen to be in a standing position, it does not matter one bit. You can be standing, you can be seated in a chair, whatever today is what you need, that is what you should do. Okay. So if you would like to join me, I would absolutely love that. So I would always start by checking in with how I'm feeling today, right? Everybody, every day is different. Some days you wake up and you go, oh, I got a little crick in my back, or well, my neck's a little tight today, or you know what? I'm just tired, but we got to figure out a way and we're going to make it happen, right? So I always do a little physical check-in and just kind of assess where am I today and what needs my attention, right? So the first thing I will always do just to kind of waken up my whole body, I absolutely love tapping. So I just kind of pat it with my skin, kind of wake up all those tissues, get them alive, get everything, get that blood flowing. I pat my chest a little bit. We'll work a little more on our ribs, but get those nice and warm, okay? Got to get that diaphragm going so that we can breathe and support our singing. Get everything warm. We're going to tap our legs. Tap our legs. Oh, feels so good. Wake it up. Wake it up, everybody, right? Wake it up, wake it up, wake it up. Okay, pat our backs, especially get back here, the backs of our ribs. We definitely thinking of our diaphragm and all of our ribs and everything like an accordion, right? Like, wow, wow. Everything should expand around. And you want to think of breathing a nice, deep, low breath. We're not breathing up from the tops of our lungs. We're breathing down below. Like thinking of a nice solid plie, those of you who dance, nice solid plie, keep those knees nice and relaxed. And those are the muscles that we're going to be engaging in order to do really good, mindful, healthy singing. So now that I feel like, okay, I checked in, we're good, I think I'm good, did my tapping, I'm just going to check in, feeling okay, feeling good, feel a little more alive and alert and more in tune than I was just a few minutes ago. So now let's work a little bit more on our rib cage and our intercostal muscles, right? So we're just gonna take nice up and over stretch, however far you need to go today. If it's only to here, don't worry. Take it every day at a time. Every day is gonna be a slightly different. So today I'm feeling pretty good. So I'm just gonna give this a nice little lean. You should feel a nice long stretch on this side of your body. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and take a nice inhale out my nose, and I'm just patting those intercostal muscles and getting them nice and warm. We're gonna pat, we're gonna rub, right? If you wanna, on your inhale, and then on your exhale, if you wanna sigh or buzz your lips, that's great too. I think I'll do a couple of those. One more. We can buzz with a little bit of a vocal trill, okay? So, wow, feels good. My arm feels nice and warm. And now I'm going to stretch to the other side. Here we go. Ah, up and over. Make sure we're breathing, everybody. Don't hold your breath and clench. Make sure you're breathing. Good. I'm going to open up those intercostals on the side. Nice little sigh. Ah, nice pats. Rub it out. How are we feeling? Good. Okay. This side will come on through. Good. Oh, wow. Feeling kind of warm. My hands are a little tingly. Get that blood flow going. How are we feeling? Hope we're doing okay. I'm going to go ahead and just push my hand forward, and I'm going to hold my fingers down. Looks like this from the side. Again, whatever you need today, you can only go a little bit. You can just go like that. Just do whatever you can do, and whatever feels good, your body will tell you what it needs. So definitely listen to it, and don't push. So nice and warm, especially for those of us who might be on our phones or our computers and typing or whatever. We're really using our hands a lot, so we've got to be mindful of them, right? We got to make sure we check in. We don't want carpal tunnel, do we? No. So I'm going to switch to the other side. I make sure I do this, especially when I'm in a performance where I have to use a handheld microphone. I think those things we forget about is, oh, I guess I should warm up my hands so that my hand doesn't hurt later after using a microphone for 2.5 hours for a concert. So, all right, now that we've got our hands nice and warm, give them a little stretch. Get those fingers. Ooh, they're cracking. My fingers are cracking. Are yours too? Okay, so I feel good. I'm going to maybe do a little few neck rolls. Oh, yeah, talk about creak, 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 crack, 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 crack. There it goes. Okay. Just nice, gentle circles. Don't go too terribly far in the back. You don't want to hurt yourself. Gonna think up and over, up and over. Good. Another one of my favorite exercises that I love to do. We used to actually use this one a lot on the national tour of Sister Act. If you're familiar with the movie with Whoopi Goldberg, I did the first national tour of that. And because of our costumes, we had what was considered nun neck. It was what they coined the term, because we had to wear the full habit and still do choreography and sing. A lot of people were getting neck injuries. So we developed a series of exercises with our physical therapist that worked on the show to help us to create exercises to not only warm up our necks more properly, but then to also cool down our necks and to cool down our bodies so that we wouldn't hopefully get injured. So one of those exercises we did was one in which we came over and we tilted our head to the side. And then by using the weight of our hand to give it just a little bit more weight, you feel a nice elongated stretch on the side of your body here, right? And then from there, we would flex our hand like this and we would go front and back. And I always used to pretend like I was petting a big puppy dog, right? The nice image of a sweet little puppy dog. We're just petting them, and you'll feel as you swing your arm like this, you just feel that stretch. It feels really good. Yeah. And then if you want to do this after you pet the puppy dog, then if you want to release your hand down, you're just going to wiggle your fingers. I used to joke that I was like reaching for a candy bar on the floor. Oh, reach it, reach it, reach it. Pick it up, pick it up. It's such a sweet treat. Ooh, get it, get it, get it. Okay, pet the puppy dog. And let your hand relax, and then you're just going to slowly roll your neck back. What a difference. Do we feel the difference between one side versus the other way? Oh my goodness. This one feels so gooey and relaxed and more free, and this side definitely needs some love. So let's fix that side, shall we? So we're going to go ahead and tip our head the other way. Use the weight of your arm on this side to help it along. Take a nice cleansing breath. Good. We're going to pet the puppy dog. Here we go. Pet the puppy. Okay. Once we pet the puppy dog, reach for the candy bar. Reach for that candy bar on the floor. Wiggle those fingers. Reach, 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 reach. Get it, get it, get it. Okay, pet the puppy dog. Relax your hand. And then slowly roll it forward back to center. Take a nice couple cleansing breaths if you can. Good. Now, yep, take a little look to one way and then the other. Back the other way and then the other. Maybe do one more little neck roll around. Good, and the other way. You know what? Here we are. Do a nice little shoulder roll. Crunch, 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 crunch. Flowing back, floating back, up, and big circles back, just like that. And then let's reverse and go the other way. Are you breathing? Make sure you're breathing. Okay. I hope we are all feeling warm and refreshed and a slightly more in tune with our bodies and just a little more relaxed than we were when we started. So that's the goal. So now that my body's feeling a little more awake and feeling good, I'm just gonna go ahead and make sure my face is all wide awake, right? Because we have to make sure we enunciate and use our consonants when we sing. So our lips need to be warm. Go ahead and do a few lip buzzes. And get our faces nice and relaxed and ooey gooey. Pretend you're chewing on a big wad of taffy. If you've ever had like really gooey candy, all right. And then if you can take your tongue, we have to warm up our tongues too. So we're gonna take our tongue and we're gonna run it around the tops and the bottom of our teeth, okay? Mm-hmm. All right, and then the other way. It's kind of like when you give a puppy some peanut butter, that face, it's that face they make, right? Anyway, warm up that tongue. Stick your tongue out, make sure your cheeks are all nice and warm, your jaw is relaxed, ready to go. Ha! Oh my goodness, how are we feeling, everybody? Are we good? I am gonna get one sip of water. So if we're gonna do some singing, we gotta make sure we're hydrated. We need to make sure we're hydrated all the time, but especially when we sing. So, wow. So here we are. And you know what? It is truly the most wonderful time of the year. I always look forward to the holidays. And even though 2020 has been much different than we had anticipated, I think every single day there's going to always be a moment where we can find something, even if it's the sheer fact that today I got out of bed. That is an accomplishment and is something to be very, very proud of. You know, having a cup of coffee or your favorite tea or whatever it is. If you've smiled today, you've had a really good day. So I just hope we all continue to find the joy in the smallest of ways and in the biggest of ways. So in honor of celebrating this most wonderful time of year, here we are. It's the most wonderful time of the year, with the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all, with those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time of the year. If you're sitting down wherever you are, just sway with me, will you? Since our bodies are nice and warm, warm up those in our gospels. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time. It's the most wonderful time. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Yay! Oh my goodness. I just love the holiday so much. I will have to say, being on contract since as being a performer, I've been very fortunate that I've been able to be in incredible locations sometimes for the holidays. I traveled with a 60-piece orchestra in Japan and did 60 concerts throughout my 4 months over there. And I got to be, of course, in Christmas time in Japan is much different than it is here in the United States. So I've done that. I worked for Holland America. So funny enough, I was sailing the ocean on Christmas and on New Year's. And I've been all over the country on national tours as well. But something is always very special when I get to be with my family here in Ohio, or truly anywhere where there's snow, which I absolutely love. And all of you down there in Texas, I know haven't seen snow lately. So I thought I would take you on a slight journey here in Ohio where we have tons of snow at the moment. I woke up yesterday morning on Christmas and it had snowed overnight from Christmas Eve into Christmas Day. And truly, having grown up with snow like this, especially after the crazy year we've had, there was no greater gift than to wake up to a beautiful, serene view of the snowfall in the morning on Christmas. So without further ado, I'd like to show you the snow here in Ohio. Look at all that snow. It's crazy, huh? We didn't get as much as we usually do, but I still say it's so beautiful, isn't it? And I will say, especially in the dark months of the winter, when so many times it can be so gloomy outside, something about the snow and all that reflecting light back up to the sky just makes it so beautiful and bright and joyful and joyous. So I'll give you a second just to enjoy the beauty that is snow, because it is such a gift, isn't it? And I will definitely say it's nice to be able to sit in here where it's nice and warm with all of you and to be able to have the very privileged view of being able to be warm and on the inside of our home to look at the snow. Okay, well, back to you in Texas. So I will say, as you obviously know, I'm obsessed with snow. So in that case, you all know that I would say, you know what? Let it snow. Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. fire is slowly dying. And my dear, we're still goodbying. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. I need a cup of hot chocolate right now, I think. I'll have to make that in a minute. Oh, the fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Oh. Okay, so I get it. All everyone in Texas is probably tired of hearing about the snow, or maybe you grew up with snow and you're thankful to be in the warmth. So you know what? I think you're right. Let's go ahead and channel the beauty that is the warm sunshine and all the joy it brings and how good it feels to maybe just sit in the sunshine and to feel the warmth of the sun and to know that there's the glow on your skin from the sun. And to listen, maybe if you're outside, you're going to hear the rustle of the trees and the birds that are chirping and all of that beautiful, beautiful warmth that comes with that. So with that, I would like you to envision a rainbow. And if you'd like to sing along with me, please do. And I'd like to share with you Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby. Skies are blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me, somewhere over the rainbow. Bluebirds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh, why can't I? Can you just picture the beautiful clouds in the sky, the birds, and the rainbow? If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbow, why, oh, why can't I? Yay. Oh, I hope that song transported you to a wonderful place. I know, even though I mentioned it's cold outside here, my heart feels warm and thinking, just dreaming about the sunshine and the warmth. So thank you all for letting me share that with you today. And I hope you enjoyed it too. So I know I did mention before that I've been very fortunate to have traveled a lot in my time with my career as a performer. And I will have to say that one of the truest highlights of my life has been to not only once do this show, but to I've done it twice now. It's Cats, the Broadway show Cats. I was fortunate enough to do the tour in 2007 and 2008, and this most recent revival of the Broadway show. And I've had the pure privilege of playing Grisabella, who sings that famous song that some of us might know, right? Called Memory. So I thought as a final gift to you today and via song, I thought I would share this version of Memory with you. So, and again, if you know it, which I'm pretty sure most of you will once you hear it, please feel free to sing along. Memory, turning your face to the moonlight, let your memory lead you, open up, enter in. If you find there the meaning of what happiness is, then a new life will begin. Memory, all alone in the moonlight, I can smile at the old days. I was beautiful then. I remember the time I knew what happiness was. Let the memory live again. Sunlight through the trees in a summer, endless masquerading like a flower as the dawn is breaking. The memory is fading. Touch me, it's so easy to leave me all alone with the memory of my days in the sun. If you touch me, you'll understand what happiness is. Look, a new day has begun. Well, thank you all so much for having me today. I hope you leave today with a lot of wonderful memories in your heart and a slightly warmer body than when we started just a half hour ago. So I hope today brought you some joy and some warmth and all of the holiday cheer that you could ask for. So thank you so, so much for having me. I hope you have a wonderful end to your 2020 and an even more fabulous start to your 2021. And you know what? I hope I get to see you again real soon. So have a wonderful day and a great weekend. And you know what? Back over to you, Fritz. You're awesome.
Trisha, that was just amazing. Your voice is so magnificent. And I'm sure everybody is feeling the emotions that come with those songs. And I thank you again. Great Age Movement, the Health Museum thanks you. And we are so lucky to experience that at the end of 2020. I think it brings hope, joy, and a sense of renewal. Again, we'd like to thank you, our audience, the people who have helped this charity, Great Age Movement, propel their mission forward. We look forward to being back in the Health Museum with our Senior Art and Exercise Program. Again, that is a workout as you move through the museum to curated music working your whole body. And we like to do that every month with our seniors. And we'll continue in 2021 with our live stream show every Saturday with all sorts of topics related to everyone, essentially, but with a focus on seniors. We're rooted in health and wellness. And to this, I say goodbye to 2020, and I look forward to seeing you in 2021. Take care and happy holidays.